出した希望はより一層その輝きを増して鮮やかな It's a brand new day The chemical go Let the way またドライ命燃やしてどまどいは Take it all away どこまでも Just leave the way 世界と You are no victory 一心に放つ
Is this really how you want to play it?
Listen, I'm being hunted too. It's only a matter of time. I can't afford sympathy. Don't waste my time. Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff. Thank you.
This is Dial's tale. Did you really kill him?
We found him dead in the Lake of Tar.
Is that so?
You can doubt me all you like, but I brought you the demon's body. Who else can say that?
True enough.
Good. Get to work on my ship, then.
I'm afraid we can't. We still need Lady Teresa's permission first.
I'm in a hurry. It would be much worse...
You wouldn't!
It's a trade. Repair the...
Very well. I'll find you your shipwrights. We'll see you at the shore.
Hey, Velvet. This would be a perfect opportunity for us to upgrade our equipment. How about it?
What are you talking about?
You don't know?
We didn't have anything like that in our village.
All the more reason, then. Come on, let's go.
Hey, you don't need to be so pushy.
That's just how I am. Get used to it. Come on. And that's how it's done. Get it?
I suppose. It seems like kind of a hassle.
Maybe at first, sure. But once you get it down, it'll be second nature. You'll eventually learn how to maximize your personal strengths through wise upgrading and dismantling.
It does seem useful.
Right? If you plan to continue your crusade, upgrading may give you the edge you need. Of course, those who are inadequately prepared for battle probably won't end up on the winning side.
That's certainly true enough. And hey, if it'll make me stronger, I'm sure I'll figure it out. If it'll help me take him down.
That navigator for the shipping guild died. He supposedly killed and ate his crewmates.
Demon Blight? In Helavise?
No need to worry. Lady Teresa is already dealing with it. She'll hunt down that Dial character in no time.
They say that once you change, you can never turn back into a human.
Killing him would be a mercy.
Yeah, you're right.
Not human, huh?
Thank you.
Well, it looks like we'll get the repairs we need.
Maybe, but that's only half of our problem. Without a proper crew, we'll wind up shipwrecked again.
We don't have time to find one, and we can't hire a ship without permission.
We'll just have to do what we can. But we've seen where my sailing skills get us.
I'm not forcing you to come. I'll do it alone if I have to.
I wonder if there are any free sailors around. Velvet, do the demons you kill turn back into humans?
Huh? What are you talking about?
Remember the demon that attacked us near the coast? When it died, it turned back into a human. Every demon I've killed has stayed a demon. So, I was just wondering what was different.
Do demons stay demons when they die? But what about Nico and the villagers I killed?
Maybe it's just a case-by-case sort of thing.
Who cares? A corpse is a corpse, whether it's human or demon.
Yeah. I guess being human again doesn't help much if you're already dead.
Exactly. All that matters is that the demons I devour make me stronger. Nothing more.
She's hopeless. Her keel's busted. It'd be faster to build a new ship.
Her keel?
You could say she's like a man with a broken back.
And how in blazes did you end up running aground here?
If you can't help, that's an...
What now? Do we try to find a new ship?
I can't think of anything else.
O Imperian Innominat, hear my prayer. Blessings and honor unto thee. This frail flesh a sacrifice to be thy foundation.
Sister.
Oh, Oscar! What brings you here? Your face! What happened to you?
A demon got the better of me. I've been summoned back to the Abbey, but I thought I'd stop by on my way.
My poor brother. I'm so sorry.
There is pain, but I can still fight. The scar will serve to remind me of my inexperience.
An underhanded foe, no doubt.
No. The demon saps her enemy's strength with her left hand and turns it against them. It was a girl with black hair and eyes full of fire. She poses a threat for even a seasoned praetor. Please, take care, dear sister.
It was her!
Teresa?
Understood. I will. Worry not. A failure as minor as this is not the end of the world.
To be honest, I came hoping you would cheer me up like that. Well, I do believe I recognize those earrings.
Of course. I treasure them dearly. Thank you.
They suit you just as well as I thought they would. I must take my leave now.
Lady Teresa, we've captured a stowaway.
I wasn't stowing away, you twit. I merely boarded without permission.
You. You're a collaborator with that demon woman. Where is she?
Your tortures are useless against the mighty Magilu! Because I'll spill my guts just fine without him!
There was word from the Abbey. They're holding a public execution for a witch who tried to draw demons into the city.
Is that so? Sounds like a real nasty character.
I'd stay away from the city if I were you. It's a common tactic for Lady Teresa.
Are you saying I'm a criminal?
That's why I'm warning you. Lady Teresa's top class, even among exorcist praetors.
A witch. It has to be Magilu, huh?
It looks like the Abbey is onto us. We'd best assume they've already found the tunnel.
No sense trying to buy a ship now.
Then don't buy one. Steal it.
Steal a ship from Helavise. Just the two of us.
We have at least one other on our side.
Dial?
He said he can navigate. If he joins forces with us, all the better.
That could be. But what happens to Magilu?
I suppose that's up to the Abbey. Let's head to Dial's cave.
Sorry, Magilu. Rest in peace.
Thank you.
You really go all out, don't you?
What do you mean?
Look, you're using Dial, threatening the guild, abandoning Mogilu. You see?
I'm not abandoning her. She can take care of herself.
Nothing stops you, does it?
There's a lot I don't understand about Mogilu, but I know she won't be killed so easily. Besides, I'm sure she's already told the Abbey everything she knows about us.
You're probably right.
That means we need an ace up our sleeve. Like a demon they believe to be dead.
One last good sharpening and I'll call this blade done. Do your blades need sharpening too? I'd be happy to take care of it for you if you want.
No thanks. I was taught never to leave my lifeline in the hands of another.
Sure. Sounds like you found a good teacher. I don't care if it's me who doesn't, as long as you're keeping them well maintained. Just in case you don't already know, after you sharpen your blades, you should rub them with clove oil and wipe them down with wool.
Yeah, I know. I was taught that too. By the man who killed my brother. Thank you.
What are you two doing back here?
Things didn't work out. We'll lend a hand with your raid.
Awfully presumptuous, aren't you?
I'm a demon. Comes with the territory.
You got me there. But are you sure? It's suicide, you know.
Maybe not. The exorcists have a hostage they're using to lure me into the city.
Then we can sneak in through the tunnel into the storehouse.
No. I expect they'll have an ambush ready there, so instead, we hit them with a direct frontal assault.
You call that a plan?
No, I call it a feint. As their forces converge on the front, a sec after that, the two groups meet up and we all sail away.
Answer me this, then. Who's making this frontal assault of yours?
I will, Nat.
That works?
Tomorrow.
Make yourself at home.
Velvet? Hey, Velvet!
Moffy?
You were crying out. Were you having a nightmare?
I was... Moffy, it was terrible!
Hey, come on, let go of me. I have to go. I have something important to do.
What's that?
Arthur told me to come meet him at the Shrine of Tranquility.
No! Listen to me! Artorias is... he's going to...
Are you all right? You were tossing and turning.
I'm fine. It was just a dream. If you don't want to go with me, I understand.
That wouldn't do. How can I repay you if you die?
You are an odd one.
Am I? I always thought of me as just me. Velvet, who's this Artorias?
My target. He killed my brother.
We're ready. Dial should be at the entrance.
Let's get going then.
Sleep well?
Just fine, thanks. And your special concoction?
Ready for deployment anytime.
Velvet.
We'll sail together if you live, Velvet.
You've got a sharp tongue.
I've always been that way.
Right then, we're off to attack Helavies. That reminds me. Where do you think that boy who took the compass ran off to?
Helavies, I'd imagine. Since Malachim are always tethered to exorcists.
That means we might run into him during our attack.
Are you getting squeamish about killing the boy because you feel indebted to him for healing you?
No. If he gets in the way, I'll take him down. But...
But?
I have to remember to thank him first.
Right.
Does that bother you at all?
No, not really. I just know that Malachim don't taste very good.
Malachim don't suit your palate? I'll call that a positive.
Thank you. goes there?
Oh, I'm pretty sure you were expecting me. They were nothing. The townspeople are gone. I was right. It's a trap.
Gave you credit for, demon lady.
You're here. You're the demon that escaped the island.
What if I am?
You hurt my dear Oscar. You will pay for that. Slowly.
See this?
Come and face me then, exorcist.
I am honor bound to aid her.
Beware her left arm.
A pair of demons should be simple for you.
Who wants to taste my blade next?
You fiends! All of this is formal! I admire your endurance, but you will regret this soon enough. Number two.
You can't finish your own work. Coward.
I won't fall for your taunts. That arm of yours is too dangerous. Besides, to dispose of demon filth, one ought to use an appropriate tool.
Well, I've got tools of my own. Tools of flamestone, sulfur, and oil.
Those will explode.
What? Our stores of flamestone! Rokuro!
I'm with you!
What are you all doing? After them!
Lady Teresa! The ships! The port! It's all on fire!
Orderlies, put out the fires at once!
Lady We're ready to set sail.
I won't let you escape. Never!
I'm a demon. Spare me your sermons.
So you can pay with your life. Praetor Teresa, I give you this order. Do it, number two!
The kid's gonna blow himself up!
To think you were a demon!
The crybaby exorcist?
I wasn't crying!
Two praetors. Not looking good.
Knock them back. That's an order. Knock them back, or I'll eat you.
An order?
Now!
Why? Why would they do such a thing to us?
We're finished! Helavis is no more!
Curse you! Curse you! Such ghastly demons! The Abbey, no, Lord Artorias himself must be informed!
Well, that turned out better than I expected. Though we wound up with a little extra.
Extra?
He looks like he'd be a scrumptious midday snack for you.
A snack?
She's just teasing.
No. If that's an order, I accept it.
Should we really be taking this kid along?
His arts will be useful to us. And we can always get rid of him.
Precisely. Malachim our tools. Use them and ditch them. Isn't that right, number two?
Yes.
Thank you. Now that was a right old conflagration. Don't think they'll be chasing after us anytime soon. You certainly didn't leave them much of a port, though. I wonder if the town will ever recover.
How much did you tell them?
I had just started episode 2, Moggy Lou's Fury, wherein the beautiful witch is captured and tortured by a demon most cruel!
I'm starting to see why they wanted to execute you. You seem busy.
We need more hands. We have to set our course and tie down the cargo. I've unfurled the sails. Does that not look safe to you?
Sure. As long as it doesn't come loose. Our destination is Logris. Set a course.
I'll do what I can, but this vessel really needs a bigger crew. We need to hire more men. Besides, if we keep sailing this way...
This is so hard to read.
Actually, you're holding it wrong. It's built to function even if the ship is rolling.
Huh. Velvet!
The heading's fine! Kid, what's your name?
Number 2.
Not that. Your real name. Surely you have one. Wanna hold it?
If that's an order...
I'm asking you what you want.
So you're ordering me to answer?
Right. You Malakim would destroy yourselves as long as it was in order, wouldn't you?
That is our purpose.
You really are tools. In that case, keep your mouth shut.
Cannon fire astern! Pirates!
That flag!
It's got to be Ifrit's pirate crew!
We can fight them there!
Huh! Look at that! They really are a bunch of demons. That works in our favor.
You knowingly pick fights with demons? Must have a death wish.
You're in trouble now that we're on land.
Wipe them out, Number 2. That's an order.
Whoa there. We're not the one you'll be fighting.
It'll be me.
A Moloch?
No, I'm the Reaper.
What is this guy?
A Moloch pirate?
A sword, twin blades, and purple. No pendulum that I can see.
Let's go! Hold stop!
you pass the test. Join us.
Well, aren't you the impudent one?
Says the demon who torched Televis.
You knew about that?
I hope you realize we're doing you a favor. If you'd stayed on that course, you would have smashed right up against the gate of Vortigern.
You guys are headed for Midgand, aren't you? That means you're gonna have to go through the Narrows up ahead. But the kingdom has a massive fortress there built to defend them, with a tremendous gate.
A fortress.
If this is true, we're in your debt.
We desire to pass through as well, but we lack the strength. I propose we form a partnership.
I'd be a fool to blindly trust the words of a pirate.
Do you really want to see the gate for yourself? We won't stop you. We'll even throw you a nice funeral if you like.
So what? We're allowed to refuse?
Your business is your business, and ours is ours. There's nothing more to say.
But First Mate, you can't go alone. We'll all come with you.
You'd only get in the way. Stick to the plan and focus on your duties aboard the Von Eltia.
What are you folks planning anyway?
Like I said, we're getting through that gate. If you're not helping us, then the conversation's over.
Is it possible to get through?
If the First Mate says he'll do it, he'll do it.
You sure put a lot of faith in him. He's a Moloch, isn't he?
That doesn't matter. He's got the captain's blessing, and that's enough for us.
Couldn't you ignore the Narrows and just sail around?
Not now. We lost both our compass and several of our crew in an earlier attack.
Compass?
Huh.
But in the end, we're pirates. If someone blocks our way, we can't just fall back.
And that's what makes a pirate, huh?
Tragically, your favorite witch is neither a sailor nor a warrior.
No argument there.
Is the Gate of Vortigern really something that impressive, Dial?
They've got a fortress and a patrolling fleet, but the gates is the real show. Even a battleship couldn't blast its way through that thing.
Is there no sea route that avoids the Narrows?
There is, so to speak, but it's a long way out into the open sea. We just end up shipwrecked.
The pirates share our goal. I don't think we have any choice but to band together.
True enough! If forward lies destruction and backward lies doom, sideways is your only option!
And yet you don't feel like helping out.
I sure don't.
That Moloch isn't all he seems. Who knows what's up his sleeves?
The kid's a Moloch, too. Hey, boy, you sense anything?
We both have ulterior motives.
Thank you.
Don't waste my time. We're finished here. Let's go.
So, you've chosen to trust a pirate?
Not for a second. But if you're prepared to lend us the use of your ship and crew until we reach the capital, we'll help you.
I'll agree to those terms. But there's something I should tell you first. I bring ill fortune to all those around me. The Reaper's Curse. I could flip this coin 1,000 times and still land on tails. Trying to get through the fort cost the lives of 5 good sailors. If you join up with me, I can't guarantee your safety.
Why would you go out of your way to warn us?
Even demons don't want to meet an unfair death, right? If you still want to come with me, just know the risks.
Works for me. I land on tails, I'll flip it to heads on my own.
Your name?
Velvet. This is number 2.
I'm Rokuro. A pleasure.
Aizen.
You've got a plan of attack, I'm sure. Let's hear it.
To put it bluntly, Vortigern is impregnable. It won't fall to an attack whether by sea or by land.
So, no plan?
Wait, what about both at once?
Exactly. First, we send in the Von Eltia to draw their fleet out of the Narrows. Then we slip inside and open the sea gate ourselves. The Von Eltia will then break away and rush back into the channel. We'll climb aboard and push through.
One slip and we're all as good as dead.
Then don't slip and we're not dead.
Walking with the Reaper, huh?
The plan is already in motion. Let's move. This cave leads to the fortress.
These vines. They're too tangled to cut through.
I'm carrying some flint. Just burn through it.
Do you really think this is a good place for us to start a fire?
Normally, no. But we're also demons and Malakim. Get what I'm saying?
Yeah, we're not exactly normal ourselves. Thank you. We're finished here. Let's go.
Kid's awfully quiet. You think maybe there's something wrong with him?
Number two's always that way.
Stop that. Calling him by a number is cruel.
What's Rokuro mean?
Well, son number six, technically.
Same thing then.
Not even remotely. You all right, kid?
Why didn't you say something? If Aizen hadn't noticed in time, you'd be dead!
Because you ordered me to keep my mouth shut.
That's not what I meant! Why? Why would you do that?
Whoa, take it easy, Velvet.
Let me guess, kid. You were bound by an exorcist? I thought as much. The boy's will has been sealed away. Malakim have individual personalities, just like humans. But exorcists have developed methods to seal those personalities away, so they can use Malakim as uncomplaining tools.
Will he always be like this?
Can't say. I've never seen one escape the exorcist before.
Listen, kid. If you're ever in trouble, speak up, okay?
If I'm in trouble?
Don't waste my time.
That wasn't worth the effort.
You said exorcists bind Malakim's free will.
Yeah. We've lived in this land a long time, and we're our own folk, just like humans. Only a small portion of humans, those with strong resonance, like the exorcists, were able to perceive our existence.
But the advent changed that.
Now Malakim can be seen by ordinary people. We're being robbed of our free will and made into obedient tools. Humans praise Artorias for providing a miraculous new weapon against demons, but Malakim aren't mere objects.
Malakim aren't things?
They are. As far as Artorias is concerned, Malakim, demons, and humans are all nothing more than tools. Everything in service to his utopia of reason. That's all anyone is to him. Even my brother.
You'll be rushed on my blade.
I wanna live. Get out of my way.
You'll be rushed on my blade.
You're wide open!
Do it again! Well, that's it! You're wide open!
We're finished here. Let's go.